Here's a heavily commented version of the logistic map code that I've showed you. MATLAB's syntax for definition of a function starts with the word function, and then there's square brackets around the stuff that you want that function to return, followed by an equal sign. Then there's the function name, and in parentheses, the arguments to this function. The square brackets in MATLAB are the way you define a vector. Down here in the command window, I'm defining the row vector that has three elements, 1, 2, and 3. So this line right here, the first line of the program, is setting up a vector that has no elements in it. And I'm setting that up so I can stuff the iterates of the logistic map into that. On line 5, I'm setting up an internal variable to store the current iterate, and I'm setting its value to the initial condition that was passed to the function. Then we go into the loop that produces the n iterates that were required of this function. In MATLAB, you don't specify the beginning and end points of the index of a loop. Rather, you give the for loop a vector containing the values that you want it to index down. In this particular case, I'm making a vector that starts at 0 and goes up to n. Let me show you how that works. By default, the spacing in the vector is 1. If you want to change that, you can by doing something like this. So this for loop is going to get executed for the index values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and on up to n. And what the guts of the for loop do are two things. First, with this line right here, it takes all of the iterates you've computed so far, sticks the current iterate onto the tail end of it, makes a new vector out of that, and replaces the old value that was in the list of iterates that you've produced so far with that new augmented value. Let me show you how that works. Here I'm making myself a row vector called foo that has four elements. By the way, the semicolon in MATLAB suppresses output. So if I were to do that same assignment of value to foo and put a semicolon afterward, it would do it. It just wouldn't tell me it did it. That's why there's all these semicolons up here. If I didn't have those, MATLAB would be telling me everything it did as it ran that function. So let's say I want to stick another number onto the tail end of foo. I would do it like this, and that returns that vector. Now notice that I didn't set that as the new value of foo, so if I just look at what's in foo, I see what was there before. But I can set that value to the new value like so. And now what's in foo is that vector with the new value on the end. The right-hand side of the last line of code inside the for loop is evaluating the logistic map for the current value of x. And then it is replacing the contents of that variable with that new calculation. So that's the updated calculation, and then it loops.